I am the owner of Elegant Nights Transportation Group, the home of Elegant Nights and the more part of us. Get on the bus and party with us. And today, I'm going to contrast and compare how to bake a cake in 10 minutes, which is a metaphor of how to build a small business. For all you cake bakers, whether you use Duncan Hines or Betty Crocker or Scratch, there are certain things that you must get out of your pantry in order to start baking cake. Of course, you're going to need a cake mixer, you're going to need a bowl, spatula, measuring utensils, a cake pan, and you have to have an oven. That's the most important thing, an oven to bake your cake. And make sure you go ahead and preheat your oven to 325 degrees. Now, this is the layout for the basic business requirements. You're going to need a business structure. You want to go ahead and pick out your business name and the structure, whether it be an LLC, sole proprietor, S-Corp, or C-Corp, whichever you want to choose, you go ahead and choose that. And try to get your name, your business name, close to what you want it to be. If you're expanding or thinking about expanding in the next few years, you may want to get a business name that includes stuff like enterprises, like Elegant Nights Enterprises or Elegant Nights Solution or Elegant Nights Services or something like that. So just go ahead and pick a name and go ahead and reserve it with the Secretary of State because you're still in your research phase now. The next thing you want to do, your business address. You want to get a professional address. A lot of times we start off on the home-based business and we want to use our home address. But when lenders are looking at you, they look at your business address. And they're going to Google your business address. And if they see a house with old raggedy, broke-down cars, grass ain't cut, you know, kids car in the yard, you know, they may not want to, they're not going to lend to you. Versus them seeing a big building that, you know, you have your business address at. So they'll look at those things as well. You want to also get you a professional fax number and business line. Don't use your personal cell number because some of y'all change your cell number every 3-4 months when you change your cab. So go ahead and get you a fax line. You may want to use a service like Ring Central or Freedom Voice or someone like that. And some of these places you can use the fax and the phone number. It's the same number. You also want to research your domain name. So you're doing all this research now because you don't want to get to have your business and everything, get it set up and everything, and then your domain, you can't even find your domain. Now you got the name of something totally from your business. So you want to go ahead and do all this laying out and research before you even get started. And GoDaddy is like $1 to reserve a name, and you can use that. If it don't work out for $1, then you don't have to renew it the next year. So the next thing you want to look at is your operating agreement. Your operating agreement is basically how you're going to operate your business. So you want to go ahead and start laying those terms out. You may not finish that initially when you get started, but it's a work in progress, your operating agreement. So now we got all our utensils, so let's get our ingredients assembled. So when you make a cake, now I heard that people say you can make some flawless cake, but I don't think I want to eat that cake. But you got everything you need for the cake. So you got your butter, sugar, your flour, your eggs, and your flavoring. Right? So it's a certain way you have to put these ingredients in your cake. You can't start with the eggs and the flour and then, you know, throw the other stuff in there. You start out with the basic stuff like your sugar and your butter. Right, cake bakers?
Yep.
Right? You have to get that all mixed up and stuff and then you start adding all this other stuff on top of it. Right? Same thing in business. So, when your business is similar, you have your structure. You have your business structure. We just talked about what you're going to be, a LLC, C-Corp, S-Corp, whatever you're going to be. We already talked about that. So we came up with LLC. We're going to use the LLC. That's the easiest thing to do with your LLC, right? So we're going to come up with a business name. We came up with our business name. It's EK Solutions. So we're not going to use nothing specific saying that like EK Credit Consultants because then you know I'm doing credit. EK Car Loan because you know I'm doing car loan. So no, we want to have something like general. I mean, it's up to you what you want to do. I'm just giving you this advice. Something like that. That way, if you change whatever you do in your business, then you won't have to change your name. Right? So we talked about a physical address where you can get one of the business addresses. Now, I don't use my home address no more because I don't learn better, so I have to do that. So now, I use another virtual office location here in Mobile, down on Water Street. So the next thing is your fax and your business phone. Like I said, you can use this and it can be the same. It can be the same fax number and phone number. like my fax number, my phone number, my virtual number, it rings to my cell phone. So I don't have to get two cell phones. So your domain name, so you had everything laid out, now you got your domain name. Your domain name matches your business name. Domain name is eksolutions.com, the same as our business name, EK Solutions. So there's no doubt about that everything is the same, right? And of course you have your operating agreement. And in your operating agreement, I'm gonna talk about those things in just a minute. So let's check on our cake. It's time to check on our cake right now. So we done put all these ingredients in, right? We done got everything mixed in. We done put it in the oven. And you know, now it's time to check on our cake, right? So now since we got everything laid out, we're gonna go ahead and register with the Secretary of State. So most everybody here is doing business with Alabama, so it'd be Alabama Secretary of State, right? So we came up with our business structure as the LLC, and the business name is Elegant Night Solution. And of course, we got our address. So once you start filling out these forms, the next agency you go to, they're gonna ask you these things. So that's why we laid out everything, so you can have everything ready when you get ready to execute. Right, so now you got your business and fax number together, and you come up with the domain www.eksolutions.com. All right, so now it's time to launch your website and your email address. So now since you have the domain eksolutions.com, your email may be mary@eksolutions.com or info@eksolutions.com or sales or whatever @eksolutions.com. So you have that, so everything is still matching across the board, right? Now, since you have your LLC set up, you have all those documents in your LLC. You have the name, you have your phone number, and you have your address, and you have all that other stuff in there. You're gonna go to the IRS.gov and get you a EIN, tax ID number, right? And when you fill out that paperwork for the EIN tax ID number, they're gonna ask you all those things that we just went over. What's your business structure, your name, your business address, and everything. So when you get to this point, then you just can fill out the paperwork because you already got the information, right? Then you're gonna go to Dun & Bradstreet and get your Dun's number. It's 100% free. And I can show you guys how to get that Dun's number, right? And then you're gonna take all this information, because when you go to the bank to open up your bank account, they're gonna ask you what's the address, what's the name of the business. Is the LLC. They're gonna ask you for your website. They're gonna ask you for your phone number. They're gonna ask you for your tax ID. They're gonna ask you for your Dun's number. So you have already got all of this stuff done. So you still making the cake, right? Put the sugar and the butter in. And see how we're building up on this, just like we're building up on this cake, right? And then you're gonna open your bank account. We got some bankers, some people that work in the banking. I'm quite sure they'll want your business too. So when you get ready to do that point, just go to them, all right? So then you still got your operating agreement, right? And then the operating agreement is the key document used by LLCs because it outlines the business financial and functions decisions, including rules, regulations, and provisions. And remember I said everything must match every document that you put. If you're gonna put LLC on this document, put LLC on that document. If you're gonna put this phone number on this document, put the same phone number on every document, right? And everything has to match. So, even your phone number, and if you got street ST, use ST, or STREET, however you use it, use that on all your documents. If you're not sure of your address, then go to Google and put the address in, and Google gonna tell you whether it's the right address or not, right? So we have everything set up the way it needs to be set up. So now we just move on, okay? So like I said, everything needs to match. Everything we're doing, it has to match. Because if a lender is looking at you to give you business, and I'm quite sure everybody want to know where the money at, how I get money for my business. Well, ain't nobody going to give you no money for your business if you ain't got your business set up the way it needs to be. You got your home address right here. You got your mama cell number over here. You got somebody else number over here. Who are you? You all over the place. So you ain't straight where you're supposed to be. Right? So they're not going to give you anything. Thank you. So when you set it up, everything got to match all the way across the board. You know how you play match game with that old maid? You flip a card and you get another card that don't match. You got to put it back and then you got to stall over until you get the right one. Well, yeah, that's it. So, okay. So in some business you have specific requirements, right? I got to hurry up. In some business you have specific requirements. Some businesses have permits, licenses, and make sure you register with the local authorities. And some people need accountant and record keeper like me. And you may be a sole proprietor or whatever, but you may not need a payroll or tip service. But if you have employees, you may want to use that. Right? So, now we got the cake. Everybody got their cake, right? All right, everybody got a piece of cake. So some people may want some frosting on their cake, right? So I like plain cake and I like, what's that red velvet, all that kind of stuff, right? So the frosting on your cake can be MailChimp, all right? MailChimp has a forever program that you can use and you can set up to what? 2,000, you can have up to 2,000 subscribers and you can send out to 12,000 emails a month for free. So y'all can use that, right? That's MailChimp. Post my wall. This is what I use. When y'all see my post on Facebook and all them things like that, then you know I just go to this site right here, and it's free to use as well, and it's free to download. And if you want the paid version, I mean, you want to use make a real big, you know, the big posters, then you have to download that paid version. But it's really inexpensive. Rush flyers. This is what I use to get my business card and stuff like that, right? And you can get 5,000 business cards for like $55. Yeah, plus shipping. Indigo, this is a free resource right here. This icing on the cake too, right? This is a automated. It's a program where you use your phone to text your business card. That's basically what this is. Social Pilot is a free resource. They got paid programs too, but the free resource is using when you want to send out automated posts like I do sometimes. I use this service. And I use another service as well because of this posting ability. Well, that's it. Elegant Nights, you're a part of us, the home of Elegant Nights Transportation Group. And some of you won't bake a cake, right? Some of you won't even get a piece of cake. Some of you won't even eat the cake. But you know, I did my best to present this cake to you. And you can take this cake and hopefully you'll use some of the information that I put out to help grow your business or help start your business. Again, my name is Mary Taylor, Elegant Nights Transportation Group, the home of Elegant Nights, and I'm a part of us. Get on the bus and part with us. All
right. This is my demon. Let me tell you about something. She saw that podium one day, she said, get that podium, because I need to hide behind that. But I want to thank you, Ms. Mary, for coming out.
Great job.
One thing she didn't, a little bit more on your company. What do you do?
I provide fun and elegant transportation.
In what formats?
For birthdays, weddings, night in the town, I'm off the clock, right? Night in the town, nights out, Mardi Gras, you know, kids' parties, duck parties, bachelor parties, anything like that. We have a party bus and it's like a nightclub on wheels. So, you know, a lot of you done been on the bus, been in the bus, been one of my customers. So, you know, I appreciate that. But the ones who have not, then, you know, maybe we can get on a party bus and bake a cake. How about that?
Okay, thank you.